युगंतः प्रविश्यमवाच मां प्रसुप्तां सञ्जीवयत्यखिलशक्तिधरस्वधाम्ना अन्यांश्च हस्तचरणश्रवणत्वकादीन् प्राणान् नमो भगवते पुरुषाय तुभ्यम् यं गुरुभिः स्वयं सत्यः प्रज्ञाभक्तिविनीतयः निहितिश्चाविव्रता नित्यं तं गुरुं प्रणमाम्यहम् सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् आप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक्प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथोबलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्म औपनिषतं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्यां मामा ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्तु अनिराकरणं मे अस्तु तदात्मनि निरते ये उपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः Let us read the verse.
Yaschittendriyamarutairanakarah netrasya netram chatam shrotra shrotramimam hrudo pirudayam vatascha vacham varam prana pranamihadhigatya kusalah आत्मानमस्तैषणाः त्यक्त्वे मां तनुमाप्नुवन्ति परमम् विष्णोः पदं शाश्वतम् चक्षुर्नाञ्चति यत्र वाग्विमलः समुदिता वाणी चयेन स्वयं बुद्ध्यायन्न मतं चयेन तु मता बुद्धिश्रवश्चक्षुषी यज्ञानादि न यद्यतो निति मरुत् तद्ब्रह्मणोपासितम्
Someone told me that the commentary for this verse as given by Ramaraja was not discussed. So let us quickly do that and then we move on to the next verse, its interpretation and so on. So as I was mentioning, the second verse of Kenopanishad, which is the 8th in the series, is a summary of the 7 mantras which we find in the first khanda of Kenopanishad. So let us read the vyakhyanam. He says, yatra yatra chakshuhu nagachati Anchati, Anchati, so in the word Anchati stems from Anchi Gatav, Anchu Mochani, both are there. So Atra, we just take the meaning Gachati. So Yatra Chakshuhu Nagachati, Yatra means Atmani, Chakshuhu Nagachati, Na Prasarati. चक्षुरग्राह्यः इत्येतत् चक्षुः बहिर्गच्छति न तु अन्तर्गच्छति सो चक्षुरग्राह्यः वागपि नाञ्चति वाचा अवाच्यः इति यावत् सो दिस् वर्ड् अवाच्यः इस् आल्सो वेरी इम्पार्टेण्ट् टु नोट् So in Sanskrit literature, we have 3 levels. Even in Sahitya, they take it a great length. Vachyarthaha, Lakshyarthaha, Vyangyarthaha. So here when we say avachyaha means vachyartha vishayo na bhavati. So that is very important. So lakshyartha vishaya it is possible. So the vachyartha vishaya we cannot accept. So that is what he explained in great length. Okay? So that is why he uses the word avachyaha. Vacha avachyaha. So otherwise this entire scripture will become meaningless. So vacha avachyaha iti yavat manascha na anchati. Manasa amantavyaha iti yavat. So how is it that we need to understand this Brahman? So amantavyaha. So as we conceive of various objects externally and keep contemplating on those objects, Brahman cannot be conceived of an object like that. Okay? So that is what is meant by nanchati manasa amantavyaha ityetat yad brahma jnatat anyat parga. Jnatat anyat manaha is explaining manaha indriya vishayam hi vastu jnatam ityuchyate. Indriya vishayam hi vastu jnatam ityuchyate. Okay, mana indriya, in fact either manaha or indriya. Okay, mana indriya vishayam hi vastu, the entity which has been captured either by mind or by indriyas. See, there are various things that we conceive of even in science. So it may not be something which is evident to you by any means that you have today, but you can still speculate the existence of it. So then we will not say it is indriya vishaya, but it is mano vishaya. So here he is saying mana indriya vishayam hi vastu jnatam ityuchyate tatha yat ajnatat api anyadeva. Why? There lies the hetu. Jnatratma bhutatvat. We are talking of an entity who is the core for you to have any kind of cognition. Jnatratma bhutatvat means jnatuhu atma bhutatvat. So the very process of jnana happens because of this conscious presence. Okay, so therefore, jnatratma bhutatvat. Then, yadgira noditam. So there I think you should split it. Yadgira. So you should have a break. It is not one single word. Yadgira noditam uditam na bhavati. Yadgira na uditam bhavati. So it is not stated by words. Yena cha vani svayam udita bhavati. By whose presence the words come. The words emanate from inside. Yena cha vani svayam samudita bhavati. So we explained all that in the previous classes in great detail. Then, yad buddhya a. Here he uses this word, yena cha vani svayam samudita bhavati. Why is this word svayam used here? Not elsewhere. So yena cha vani udita bhavati could be okay. So yena chakshuhu anchati, yena manaha prasarati, yena vani. So there is a certain distinction if you see between this and vani. So if I have to see you, then initially I have to focus my attention, then certain things have to get in. And then it has to go and register, right? So there is a process initially and there is a process later. Now when they get a vani, that's all. Initially process, air hits, comes out on its own. There is no other vyapara there. That there is a certain intent, and that intent actually prompts and it goes out. So there is no further vyapara inside. So here, that is what he. Yena cha vani svayam samudita bhavati. Yet buddhya namatam na buddham. Yena cha buddhireva mata buddha. Yet shravaschakshuhi. So there is a word missing here. Should be najanati. I think the na, there is a typographical error. See, in the verse you have that na. Yet shravaschakshuhi na janati. In fact, while doing Vyakhyana also he says, shravaschakshuhi tu yanna janitaha. In fact, of course, the vachana viparyaya has to be done. In certain places we do. So that is how he just says. So that is fine. But here, this nany is missing. Okay? So while doing the anuvada, shravaschakshuhi means shravaha chakshuhu, both. Shravaha and chakshuhu. Shravaha katham? Shravaha ityukto? Shravaha ityukto shravanendriyam ityartha. Katham shabdaha nishpadyate? So in fact, I was looking at this, the vyutpatti. So there is a very interesting sutra which actually has been given by Panini to take care of a few words. So the sutra is a very small sutra, but it covers several words which we are quite familiar with. Today as I was looking into that, so I was quite fascinated. The sutra is Rudorapu. Repeat. Rudorapu. Rudorapu. Okay. Apu is the suffix. So which is being fixed here. Rudorapu, he says, R is, so that Rukara, Dirka. Okay. So if a word ends with, or rather the verb ends with
root.
The verb, root. Okay. So the root of the verb ends with Dirgha Ru. Or it ends with U. Then a certain suffix called up gets fixed to it. Okay. Now this is very simple. If I give you a few examples, you will be able to very easily see that. Shravaha is one example. What is the dhatu?
Shru.
Shru. Shru is the dhatu. And in shru, we have the ending u. And the suffix is up. So this apratyaya, actually you can use it in karmani or you can use in karani. So you can actually say, so here it has been employed in karani. But though the prakarana is primarily karma and bhava prakarana, so these suffixes are basically in that. But this word itself demands that it is used in karana also. Because shru, shruyate anena, iti shravaha. So shruyate, see, shruyate iti shravaha. Okay? The other word, if you just say karmani, then it means shabda. So karmani, if you use this suffix, it refers to shabda. So karane, if you use, it refers to the indriya. So here it has been employed in the sense of indriya. Okay? Shru, apu, shravaha. Actually, there are a few other examples which have been given. One example is karaha. Karaha, garaha, sharaha. All are used. So, sharaha, you know, what is sharaha? Arrow. Okay. So it actually comes from Shri Himsaya. Okay. Shri Shiryate. So Shiryate means that which sort of fades, that which like split kind of a thing. Now this Sharaha does that. In fact, this word which we are most familiar with, Sharira, it also comes from Shri. And there it actually means Himsaya. So how do you use? Why is the Himsa? So you don't do Himsa. But the Himsa is done by this Roga. Everyone is worried, right? You just take Shiryate Shariram. Finish. Right? Shiryate Iti Shariram. So the very word actually gives us the hint. So Shiryate, so there it is actually Iran Pratyaya, but the Dhatu is same. So that Sharaha is basically coming from Shri Apu. Okay, that Pa anyway gets dropped. Okay, so you will have Sharaha is the form. Okay, so that is Karana Karani. So if you use this Iran, it should be Karmani. Shiryate Iti Shariram. So this Sharaha, Karaha. So Karaha, there is a Kru, it should be. But if you say Kru, Karoti, so that will not come. Okay. So this Sutra will sort of try to prevent. Okay. But anyway, so this Kru, but you should use some other suffix then. Okay, so you should use ach and karoti iti karaha, you can bring in. But here the word karaha, I was thinking, kiryate. Kiryate. So then it can actually mean tax. How? So karmani, so this fellow is supposed to collect all this and then he will distribute. In fact, we have in Raghuvamsa, no? Prajanameva bhutyartham satabhyo balimagrahit sahasragunamutsrashtum adatye hirasam ravihi. So karaha means balihi, tax. So Dilipa was collecting prajanameva bhutyartham for the welfare of his own subjects. That is what he was doing. Okay. Prajanameva bhutyartham satabhyo balimagrahit. That is how the word karaha. So karaha, shravaha, lavaha, sharaha. So all these words basically come from rudhorapu. Repeat. Rudhorapu. Okay. So this is a very interesting sutra which has been written by Panini in order to explain the derivation of these words. So here, yet shravaschakshuhi na janati, shravaschakshuhi tu yen na janati, iti viparinamaha, janitaha iti viparinamaha, then marut pranaha yataha yasmat dhetoho aniti praniti tad brahma bhavati. So that is what he finally says. So this upasitam, anyway, we explained in great detail. Upasitam tu brahmana bhavati. Upasitasya vai indriya hridaya vishayatvad brahmanascha tad avishayatvad. Upasitam yadvastu tat indriya mano vishayam. So ayantu na upasito bhavati. So therefore he says brahmanascha tad avishayatvat tasmat upasakasya atma eva brahmeti paramartha. This is something which we need to understand very, very clearly. He would have simply said upasakaha brahma atma. Brahma, he could have said upasakaha brahma. He doesn't say upasakasya atma brahma. So whenever you use the word upasaka, it is connected with a certain kriya and manaha is involved. Without that, you cannot employ the word upasaka. Here you want to eliminate that and you wanted to say nirdharmakam idam brahma without any upadhi, and therefore he is saying upasakasya atma eva brahmeti paramartha. The moment you say upasaka is brahma, so then nanatvam comes. Atmaikattvam is what we need to establish here, and therefore you cannot say. Similarly, you cannot say shrota, vakta, you cannot say. So in fact, there is a very interesting discussion in the next khanda, right, in the first mantra. So you may see that in later, greater detail. Okay, now let us read the next verse.
Vedaham brahaditya vaiti manasa.
Vedaham brahaditya vaiti manasa. Vedaham brahaditya vaiti manasa.
Yovedadabhram satat.
Yovedadabhram satat.
Yovedadabhram satat. No vedasmi na vedane dimanute.
No vedasmi na vedane dimanute. No vedasmi na vedane dimanute.
Yo veda samyak satat.
Yo veda samyak satat. Yo veda samyak satat.
Vijnatam tvijanatam brihat brihat.
Vijnatam tvijanatam brihat. Vijnatam tvijanatam brihat.
Avijnatam punarjanatam.
Avijnatam punarjanatam. Avijnatam punarjanatam.
Jnatam me pratibodhame taditi tat.
Jnatam me pratibodhame taditi tat. Jnatam me pratibodhame taditi tat.
Matva mritam vindate.
Matva mritam vindate. Matva mritam vindate.
So this verse 9 and verse 10 together capture 5 mantras that are there in the second khanda. So of the 5 mantras, 4 mantras have been summarized in this verse 9. And one mantra, so he has allotted one more verse for that. Okay, that is the last. So we will see that as we proceed later. Now, as far as this verse is concerned, it actually explains the first mantra, yadi manyase suvedeti dabhramevapi nunam tvam vetha brahmano rupam yadasyattam yadasu yadasya deveshu athanu mimamsyamevate manye viditam. So mimamsyameva tat viditam. So mimamsyam means to be further inquired. To be further inquired only when you do not know. Only when you have not properly understood. So we would just say you may have to further make inquiries. Now vedaham brihat. Aham brihad veda. Suppose you say avaiti manasa yo veda. Yaha manasa aham brihad vedeti veda. So iti yaha avaiti. So the one who knows so सतत ब्रह्म दभ्रम वेदा ही नोज ओनली लिटिल इन मंत्रा एम्फसाइजेस दैट मंत्रा एम्फसाइजेस दैट दिस पर्सन हैज टू डू फर्दर मीमांसा बट दैट स्टेटमेंट हैज नॉट बीन मेड बाय हिम बिकॉज ही इज जस्ट कंडेंसिंग द फर्स्ट मंत्रा इन फर्स्ट क्वार्टर सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी वर लुकिंग एट द कमेंटरी of Bhagavad Pada, there is something which is actually very very interesting here. So I thought I will just share that with you before proceeding further. Okay. So in the last class, I was just looking at the commentary of the first mantra in the Keno Upanishad, second khanda. So here he is saying, Idam Brahmeti Sunishchitoktamapi विषम प्रतिपत्तित्वात् यदि मन्यसे इत्यादि साशंकं वचनं युक्तमेव आचार्यस्य आचार्यस्य वचनं युक्तमेव सो इफ यू से दैट आई नो वेल देन सो यथनु मीमांस्यम व्हाटएवर आचार्य सेड इज Yuktam means it is appropriate. So here Bhagavad Pada takes on the word Dabhram and makes some interesting analysis. He says Dabhram means Alpam. Dabhram eva vinunam tambetha. See, this is a very very intricate topic because the Shruti, I can only give one example which many of you may be familiar with. Just to relate how complicated it is. If you say that I have understood light, where did you understand, in what context? So from the viewpoint of physics, so I have understood in this particular phenomenon, I have seen a prism, I mean there is a white light passes and then it turns into various colors, I am able to see and project it on the screen, etc. So then you will say it is exhibiting some wave property. Why does it split? There are various frequencies, they bend in various ways and therefore different colors are thrown. I will explain. But there are certain other contexts in which you have to completely abandon this and then accept it as a particle and not as a wave. How will you describe this entity, suppose I ask? This entity with which we are absolutely familiar with, how would you explain its nature? The nature of it, it is exhibited in a particular way, in a particular experiment. It has to be taken completely differently in a different environment, in a different experiment, which cannot be easily reconciled. And therefore, people suggest that vehicle, wave and particle. It is actually neither a wave nor a particle. Then what is it? It is what it is. So those who have very deeply contemplated on this, it is what it is. We can explain this by taking this model. We can explain this by taking this model. So this is how it comes. Even for this entity which I am talking about, which we are fairly familiar with, so too here, when we are discussing this nature of Atman, it is in the light of various Shrutis that we have here. There are certain Shrutis which explain this as Prajnanam Brahma, there are certain Shrutis which explain this as Anandam Brahma, there are certain Shrutis which explain this as Shruti Vijnatran. On all that, what is it actually? If you take this viewpoint, then I may have to describe it this way. If you take this viewpoint, then I may have to describe it this way. But what this Keno Upanishad does is, so it actually probes very deeply into this question, and therefore we need to look into the Bhagavad Pada's commentary here, which is very brilliantly bringing out certain aspects. So here he says, Dabhrameva. If you describe light as wave, then Dabhrameva Vetha, I will say. If you describe light as particle, Dabhrameva Tum Vetha. Then what will you describe? I will say neither it is wave nor it is avijnatam. Neither vijnatam nor avijnatam. I am just giving you a simile. Okay, so just understand this. Now, so dabhrameva alpameva pinunam tum vetha janishe brahmano rupam. So now he is asking this question. You have understood only little. For this, Acharya is asking the question, Kim anekani brahmano rupani? Kim anekani brahmano rupani? Mahanti arbhakani cha? Yena aha dabhrame veti. So it's a lot more to understand when you say, you have understood some aspect, you have not understood many other things, and therefore I will say, you have only understood little, there is a lot more to understand. Okay? So there are so many forms, so you have known only one particular thing and therefore is it Dabhram? So the answer is Badham. Badham is a special usage. So Satyam is sometimes used, Badham is used. Yes, certainly sir. Okay. So that is what is meant by Badham. So forcefully expressing. So Badham, completely agree. But then it says, अनेकानि नाम रूप उपाधिकृतानि ब्रह्मणो रूपाणि न स्वतः. Do you know world? Yes, I know. So I know this thing. I know this. I know that. I know that. Is ring gold? Is bangle gold? So, nama rupa upadhi krita. So, we just drop this and then see that entity. Is there multiple things? Yes, I know. Multiple things are there. But, all this is upadhi vishishtam brahma. I will not say it is not brahma, but sopadhikam brahma. Now, he says, anekanihi nama rupa upadhi kritani brahmano rupani. Why should you make this statement? Because it is this Brahman which has taken various forms. That is the only upadana karana. So we are describing Brahman as upadana for the entire jagat, and therefore you cannot say this is not Brahman. So how will you say then? I have to say that this is Brahman, but sopadhikam, along with upadhi. It is like this, seeing gold as a ring. You will either see it as a ring or you see it as a biscuit. But throwing out this upadhi, you try to understand this entity. So similarly, here we are trying to say, anekanihi namarupa upadhikritani brahmano rupani. Natu svataha. Gold is different from any of this nama rupa. Natu svataha. Svatastu, what is it? Asabdamasparisham arupam avyam tatharasam nityam agandhavaccha yat anadyanantam hatah parandhruvam nichayyatam mrityumukhatra muchyate. That is how the Kathopanishad mantra goes. Ashabdamasparisham arupam avyam tatha arasam. So now you have to explain this mantra. So it is primarily, this is what is being stated in various mantras here. So yet shrotrena shrunoti yena shrotramidam shrutam yet chakshushana pasyati yena chakshum shipasyati. So that is what is ashabdam asparisham arupam avyayam tatha arasam. So these are terms which have been employed to describe this. तथा रसम नित्यमगंधवच्चा। नाउ इति शब्दादिभिः सह रूपाणि प्रतिषिध्यन्ते। सो शब्दादिभिः सह रूपाणि प्रतिषिध्यन्ते। नाउ ही आस्क्स अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन। दिस क्वेश्चन इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग। ही सेज ननु येनैव धर्मेण यद्रूप्यते तदेव तस्य स्वरूपमिति ब्रह्मणोपि येन विशेषणेन निरूपणं तदेव तस्य स्वरूपं स्यात्। इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन। रूप्यते मीन्स डिस्क्राइब अंडरस्टूड। रूप्यते मीन्स डिस्क्राइब अंडरस्टूड। सो सपोज यू वांट टू से somebody speaks so ferociously, what will you say? He is a firebrand. So we just have various terms to describe. Okay, he is a kopishtha, he is a vachala. So we can use various terms to describe. Okay, येनैव धर्मेण यत् रूप्यते। वेरी सिंपल, यू टेक द वर्ड दाहक। व्हाट इज द धर्म फॉर अग्नि? दहनम। सो यू डिस्क्राइब इट एज दाहक। इन फैक्ट वी हैव अ डिस्क्रिप्शन इन आर्यभटीय, चंद्रो जलम अर्कोग्नि। बड़ी सुल्टा चंद्रोजलम अर्कोग्नि। अर्क अग्नि अब येनैव यद्रूप्यते। सो दैट इज व्हाट ही इज ट्राइंग टू से, येनैव धर्मेण यद्रूप्यते तदेव तस्य स्वरूपम्। सो ब्रह्मणोपि येन विशेषेण निरूपणम् तदेव तस्य स्वरूपम् स्यात्। So this question is based on this arupa. Why do you want to say? Suppose something is very peculiar to you, you describe it by that term. What is wrong? Ata uchyate. He says chaitanyam. What is this rupa that you have in your mind, which makes you object the description arupa? Question is, what Shankaracharya has in his mind is Bhagavad Pada. So he is just saying, yenaiva dharmena yadrupyate tadeva tasya swarupam. Okay. So dahaka is just one simple example which you can appreciate. Agnehe swarupam kim? Dahaka. Therefore you describe it as dahaka. Similarly, chaitanyam brahma you say. It is not even arupa. So that is what actually one means here. Yakeva. Janim tadeva chaitanyam eva tatsya swarupam iti chaitanyam brahma iti ichyatam. Chaitanyam eva teneva tadrupyate. After all that you did was, till now, yena shrotram idam shrutam, yena ahur manomatam. What did you want to convey? There is a certain conscious being. So consciousness is the form of Brahman. Tadeva tasya rupam. Consciousness is arupam iti kutha vakshyate. So that is the question. Okay? So anyway, rupa should not be just taken as form here. So, it is tadeva tasya swarupam. Now he says, Ada Uchyate Chaitanyam. So now he further classifies. He says, this Chaitanyam is something which is so unique to this. So, Prithivyadinam Anyatamasya Sarvesham Viparinatam विपरिणतानां वा धर्मो न भवति. विपरिणतानां मीन्स भौतिकम्. सो यू टेक पृथ्वी आदि पंचभूता, नन ऑफ देम हैव दिस चैतन्य. सो पृथ्वी आदि भूता दे डोंट हैव चैतन्य. नॉन ऑफ द भौतिकास हैव चैतन्य. So there is only one entity which you can think of having chaitanyam, that is Brahman. Prithivyadinam anyatamasya sarvesham viparinatanam va dharmo na bhavati. Tatha shrotradinam antahkaranasya cha dharmo na bhavati. So the shrotram, manaha, etc., they are actually bhautika padarth. When you say shrotram, it refers to the shakuli, it refers to the snapaha, it refers to something inside, it refers to some cochlea, whatever it is. They are all bhautika padarthas. So none of them have this chaitanya. So neither bhutas or bhautikas, they do not have chaitanyam. So chaitanyam is something which is unique to Brahman. So he is asking this question. Shrotradinam antahkarnasya dharmo na bhavati iti ब्रह्मणो रूपमिति ब्रह्म रूप्यते चैतन्येन. रूप्यते मीन्स निरूप्यते, दैट इज हाउ वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड एस्टैब्लिश्ड. ओके, सो चैतन्येन एतत् रूप्यते, कुतः अरूपमिति. सो येनैव, सो इट इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग, येन धर्मेण यद्रूप्यते, येन धर्मेण यद् रूप्यते तदेव तस्य स्वरूपम्. हियर दिस चैतन्यम इज समथिंग विच सीम्स टू बी यूनिक टू द एंटिटी विच यू आर डिस्क्राइबिंग एंड देयरफॉर वी विल टेक इट दैट वे. अरूपम हाउ यू से. सो हियर द क्वेश्चन, द आंसर ही सेज इज तथा च उक्तम. इन फैक्ट ही कोट्स श्रुतिस. विज्ञानमानंदम ब्रह्म विज्ञानघन एव सत्यम ज्ञानमनंतं ब्रह्म प्रज्ञानं ब्रह्म. ब्रह्मणः रूपं निर्दिष्टं श्रुतिषु. ब्रह्मणः श्रुतिषु रूपं निर्दिष्टं. सो हाउ आर यू गोइंग टू रिकन्साइल दिस स्टेटमेंट अरूपा हियर विच यू फाइंड हियर. And these shrutis which are describing Brahman by the word vijnanam, prajnanam and so on. Okay? It's a very interesting question that he poses. Now, Acharya says, satyam evam. Yes sir, I agree. Okay? Satyam evam. Tathapi. This is a very subtle point which we need to carefully follow. तथापि हि सेज तदंतःकरण देहेन्द्रिय उपाधिद्वारेणैव विज्ञानादि शब्दैः निर्दिश्यते. इट इज वेरी वेरी केयरफुली यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड. सो ऑल दीस ही हैज इन हिज माइंड द एंटायर डिस्कशन विच वेंट थ्रू यन मनसा नमनुते येनाहुर् मनोमतम्. Now he is having all this in mind and then he says, Satyam. Even when I describe, or rather Shruti describes, this Brahman as Vijnanam Brahman or Anando Brahman. So we need to understand that as this Shruti gets into your mind, is not Antahkarana involved in the process? In understanding this as vijnana. You get the point? So he is trying to say, tadantahkarana dehendriya upadhidvareneiva vijnanadi shabdaihi nirdishyati. So when you try to understand something, you try to understand by bringing in this antahkarana. Manasa namunute yenahur manomatam, even when you say, So this vijnanam is a certain cognition that arises, and the cognition that arises only arises when the mind is associated with it. When the mind is dysfunctional, there is no cognition. So even when you try to understand the Shruti, so prajnanam brahma or satyam brahma, so this antahkarana plays a role. Now he is saying, he tad antahkarana dehendriya upadhidvare naiva vijnanadi shabdaihi nirdishyate. So this understood, this entity which is understood, okay. So why is he bringing this discussion? This discussion is primarily to justify why we are struggling hard, or this Upanishad tries to struggle hard. To just say anyadeva tadvijitat atho avijitadabhi. The other day I was quoting, vedniti yadbaladatha na vedniti yadbalad. Now there are two aspects which are there. That is why I told you, na vachyam apitu lakshyam. It is not something which has become a vachya, but it is understood through lakshana. So now he is saying, further he says, what does this mean? This essentially means that you have not understood this Brahman as nirupadhika, but only as a sopadhika, because the mind was involved with this. Okay? Suppose you understand as Vedita, then this Veditrittvam cannot be disconnected from mind. And therefore, he is just saying, the upadhidvareneva vijnanadi shabdaihi nirdishyate. Now, then further he says, tad anukaritvad dehadi vriddhi sankocha chedadishu nasheshuka nasvataha. In fact, he further extends it. The idea here is simple. You can ask this question, that what did you finally try to convey to me? I have understood this Atman as Sopadhika. I have understood only Sopadhika Brahman, not Nirupadhika. Right? This is what you are trying to convey to me. So Upadhi is Antahkarana and Upahita is the Chaitanya. Right? So this Upahitam is Chaitanya, that cannot be associated with this Upadhi. After all, you say Chaitanya is something which is not connected with anything. Okay? Swacham. So it is not associated with anything. How can you say that this Chaitanya which is Asanga, how is it connected with the Upadhi? Whenever you say Upadhi, Upadhi is always samsrishta. So this is the question that he has in his mind. But then he says, tad anukaritvat vehari vriddhi sankocha. In fact, this Upadhi is something which you cannot simply disconnect. It is not that it has to be physically present. So tadharmasya anukari bhavati. It essentially means, I give you one simple example. Now, suppose we just think of, so the reflection of sun in a tub of water. Is sun connected with this? Not connected. Right? So sun is not connected. It is, in fact, sun illuminates this. You describe this water as Upadhi now. So the reflected element here, the nature of this reflected element, okay, suppose you have different kinds of water, then you will see variation in the quality of this reflected element. It is like this, you go in front of mirror, you are one single person, but you see a variety of your faces. So in, sometimes in this toilet you go. First time when I went, I was quite surprised. So in one of the 5-star hotels, face was so big. I said, what is this that they are kept? So perhaps to see the minute things. Anyway, so the point is, vastu is same, but upadhikrita bhedaha, you see. Right? Now this upadhi need not actually be physically connected, but you can see that it cannot be without this upadhi. So this upadhikrita, see the point is, in the upahita, the point one has to understand is, this upahitam chaitanyam is affected by upadhi, though it need not be physically connected with that. So my face in the mirror is upahitam. So that is what I see. So when I understand even this entity, so you have to very clearly follow. So this entity which I am trying to understand, okay, as Atman, is absolutely not connected with any of these upadhis. But when I bring in this notion of prajnanam brahma and so on and so forth, if I say so, so then in the process of understanding this, my antakarana is involved, and that is how I understand this as jnata. So therefore he is trying to bring in this svatastu, and this is something which gets extended not only to this phenomenon of understanding with all this sarirendriya. So that is why he is using the second part of it. Tad anukarittvat dehadi vriddhi. So all these notions that you have is essentially tagged to this. Svatastu, what is its nature? Avijnatam vijanatam vijnatam avijanatam. So this is mantra which he is going to come little later in this, the third mantra in this. Iti sthitam bhavati. Now, in order to complete this mantra, so anyway we will once again come back to this, okay, when we discuss the meaning of the next mantra. So here he says, yadasya brahmano rupam iti purvena sambandhaha. Okay, so in the mantra we have, यदि मन्यसे सुवेदेरि दभ्रमेवाभिनूनं तुम वेद सब्रह्मणो रूपं यदस्य त्वं इति. सो यदस्य शुड बी टेकन बिफोर दैट इज व्हाट ही इज ट्राइंग टू से. यदस्य ब्रह्मणो रूपं इति पूर्वेण संबंधः. ओके, दैट यदस्य वन वी मिस्टेक इट टू बी कमिंग लेटर. सो यदि मन्यसे सुवेदेति दभ्रमेवाभिनूनं तुम वेद सब्रह्मणो यदस्य ब्रह्मणो रूपं, दैट इज हाउ यू हैव टू डू द अन्वय. इति पूर्वेण संबंधः न केवलम् अध्यात्मोपा. इन फैक्ट ही सेज इट इज नॉट नेसेसरली दिस अध्यात्म उपाधि दैट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट. अध्यात्मम मींस समथिंग विच हैज टू डू विद दिस शरीर विद दिस मनस विद दिस इंद्रिय. सो इट हैज टू डू विद एनी अदर उपाधि ऑल्सो. यदस्य देवेषु. So suppose you say, I am Aditya, Brahman. Some other thing as Brahman, if you describe. So he says, for that, yadapi adhidaivatopadhiparichinnasya brahmano rupam. Suppose you give any kind of description, okay, of this Brahman. So not in this particular world. This is very easy for us to conceive of. I'll tell you, any of these descriptions that you find, even here, we may be able to easily digest. We cannot say that it is impossible. That is all I will just say. See, we can neither say it is possible, nor say it is impossible. Why? Simply because you can think of various living organisms whose lifetime is so small. Our lifetime is huge. 10 to the power of 5 times, 10 to the power of 6 times, 10 to the power of 8 times. So depending upon which organism you choose as reference. So similarly, one can think of something which is much, 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 much long-lived than us, more comfort than us, whatever it is. Suppose you just take some fellow who has lived only in gullies, okay, to some villas, either in India or elsewhere, what will he think of? Ah, this is Swarga. So here, that is how, so here he is saying, Adhidaivata basically refers to something. Yadapyadhidaivatopadhipadichinnasyasya brahmanorupam deveshu vetsatvam. Whatever you conceive of, whatever you find the description of Brahman, okay? Vetsatvam tadabhinunam dabhrameva vetha. So when he said, so this dabhrameva vetha, so he is trying to explain all that from the mantra. Then, adhyatmam yadapi deveshu tadapiche upadhi parichinnatvat dabhratvan nanivartate. So whether it is adhidevatam, whether it is adhibhutam, whether it is adhyatmam, all of them are connected with upadhi, and therefore dabhrameva vetha. So you have not completely understood. Yet to finally he says, Vidvasta Sarvopadhi Vishesham. Okay. Vidvasta Sarvopadhi Vishesham. I can only think of the descriptions that we find when we go to the philosophy of physics. So many things, I mean, you can explain. Okay. So suppose you ask this question, what is number in mathematics? The entire world will be playing with numbers. So suppose you ask, what is number? Suppose you ask, what is life? Very difficult. What is time? The time. See, the time is 6 seconds. Not time. Okay. So now, yattu vidvasta sarvopadhi vishesham शांतम अनंतम अनेकम अद्वैतम भूमाख्यम नित्यम ब्रह्म नतत सुवेदेत्यभिप्रायः. नतत सुवेदेत्यभिप्रायः यत एवम् अथन अथनु अथनु हियर मीन्स तस्मात् अथनु मीमांस्यमेव. दिस अथ हैज वेरियस मीनिंग्स. So here, tasmat is artha. So this artha, very interesting. So there are various meanings, anantaryam and so on. Athanu tasmat manye adhyabhi mimamsyam vichadhyamevate tavabrahma evam acharyoktaha shishyaha. So this is something really very interesting. What did the fellow do? Evam acharyoktaha shishyaha. एकांते गोष्ठः इवेंट्स एंड देयर समाहितसन. सो ही कलेक्टेड ऑल हिज थॉट्स. ओके. सो ही वाज कंटेंप्लेटिंग डीपली. समाहितसन यथोक्तम आचार्येण आगमम अर्थतो विचार्य. अर्थतो विचार्य मींस ही गॉट द सब्सटेंस ऑफ दैट. सो डीपली कंटेंप्लेटिंग ऑल दैट. ओके. The substance of what he was trying to say, shrotasya shrotam manaso mana, whatever it is. Yathoktam acharyena agamam. He said, iti sushruma purvesham agamam vicharya. Then, tarkatascha nirdharya. So, understanding the heart of it, finally he says, svanubhavam krutva. It also very important. Svanubhavam krutva acharya sakasam upagamya bubacha. He just goes to the avatarika of the next mantra. Nahamanye suve devi mona vede ti vedacha yonastad veda tad veda मुन वेदेति वेदचा सेकंड मंत्र इन फैक्ट दट इज व्हाट इज द सेकंड क्वार्टर ऑफ दिस वर्स नो वेदास्मि न वेदनेति मनुधेयो वेद सम्यक् सतत सो दिस इज द रिप्लाई दट ही गेव टू द आचार्य सो दिस उपनिषद इज एक्चुअली वेरी 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 इंटरेस्टिंग उपनिषद सो विच ट्राइज टू ब्रिंग इन दिस कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ब्रह्मन एज समथिंग विच कैन नॉट बी सिंपली एक्सप्लिकेटेड बाई वर्ड्स सो दिस इज ए डीप एनालिसिस विच हैज गॉन एंड फॉर वन टू रियली अप्रिशिएट So one has to get deep into the philosophy of any of the subject matters. So if you look at the fundamental question, so what is it that we are trying to describe? We are trying to describe an entity which is the cause for every entity. So if you associate with any of them, so then we will find various problems which we will land into. So nitya, dharmaka, etc., etc. Which are anyway not permanent, and what should be the characteristics with which we will be able to make a distinction of this from any of these, and how do we actually bring in the samanjasyam, is what is the term that we will use, okay, for all these mantras. So that is where this crux lies. So I think we'll stop here. Om. सर्वे सुखिनः सन्तु सर्वे सन्तु निरामयाः सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत् ॐ